ladies and gentlemen, welcome, welcome, welcome. It's time for a brand new episode of As the Buckle Turns, the number one podcast, wrestling podcast from the 01 podcast group. I'm Adam.
I'm Tim.
How you doing, Tim? I don't care. Moving on.
That was a lot of welcomes.
I know.
In this opening.
I gotta throw them out there every once in a while.
So we're the number one podcast in wrestling.
We're the number one wrestling podcast and the number one podcast from the 01 podcast group.
But we're our number one podcast outside the number one. Yeah.
No, not at all.
No,
I mean, exactly. Also, we're the only podcast on the channel right now.
Oh, really?
So yeah, we're number one right there.
Wow.
highest listened to podcast from the 01 podcast group as well. We are racking up the awards this year.
Oh yeah,
I cannot wait to reap the benefits.
Exactly.
You know, I heard from the boss that there's going to be a great bonus this year.
You're the boss,
Tim. You're doing a great job.
Exactly.
There's your bonus.
Thank you. I'm getting triple my bonus, my pay, right?
Oh yeah, so your yearly salary, triple it. That's your bonus this month for the end of the year.
Let's see. Okay, so I get paid $0 if you triple that.
Yep.
That's 4 zeros.
Yep.
Awesome. I get 4 zeros this year instead of.
Yep.
Nothing before the zeros, just zeros.
Just a lot of zeros.
There we go.
Anyway, we have predictions this week for two shows.
Yes. Well, one of them is not really going to count towards our average. We're just going to do
it. Oh, I'm going to count it.
No, we're not.
Why not?
Because it'll screw everything up with the WWE.
Maybe
if we want to do that next year, we can start counting them.
Okay.
I just thought, because tonight we're recording this on
the 15th.
The 15th of Friday. And tonight, they're actually, Ring of Honor is having their final battle pay-per-view.
Yep.
So I figured, why not throw on? There's nothing really newsworthy that much.
Nope.
Why not try to predict a show that we don't really watch at all?
And we don't understand their booking that well.
No, exactly. So
I mean, it's coming to you from the Hammerstein Ballroom in New York City.
Yep.
I've been there for a couple of shows. Absolutely wonderful venue. I've never seen wrestling there yet, and I would love to.
Yeah.
I mean, outside of watching, like, the TV or taped programs that have been there in the past.
Yeah.
Outside of that, I haven't been there live yet.
Yeah. So we figured we'd do that.
Yeah, why not?
And then we do have a little news, but nothing much. Like I said, it's almost Christmas time.
Yeah.
Nothing happens around this time.
No, and then we've got, next week one more show, and then we're going to take our little break, and then we'll be back just after Wrestle Kingdom 12.
Oh, speaking of Wrestle Kingdom 12,
yes,
it's official.
What is?
It is 100% official.
What is?
This year,
yeah,
I will watch the entire Wrestle Kingdom card.
Instead of
just one match.
Just the couple of matches. Yeah, no, I'm going to be watching the entire card.
Last year I only watched one match.
Oh. I at least went back and watched the Young Buck. No, it wasn't the Young
Buck.
It was the other Bullet Club match that happened early in the card.
Nope, I didn't even watch that. No, I watched Nakamura.
Dominion, I watched a lot of it.
Not Nakamura. Okada versus Omega. That's the only match I watched.
Which is
same thing.
Which is poetry in the ring.
And then Okada Omega 2, I only watched that too.
Oh, I watched that card. That was actually a wonderful, fun card to watch.
So I will watch the entire Wrestle Kingdom card. How long will it take me to watch it? That is we're talking, it could be weeks, because it's going to be about probably a 5 to 6 hour show.
Yep.
And I'm going to be watching in chunks.
All right.
And that's like one day I just get really, really bored and decide, fuck it, I'm just going to put it on and watch it. But we'll see. But I do plan on going through the entire show. And that means from start to finish, I'm not going to jump to watch the matches I want to see and then go back.
Oh, you're going
to
watch it in order.
In order, because if I watch the matches I want to watch, I won't go back and watch the other stuff.
All right.
I still haven't watched the U.S. tournament, and I have both the two-day program on my computer. I haven't even looked at them yet.
Oh, okay.
So that just tells you where I am on that.
It looks like a fun, fun card right now.
Yeah.
All right. So let's go ahead and let's hit the weird news that probably very few people caught until today. Maybe they'll catch
Disney buys 21st Century Fox.
You'd have to have your head in the sand to not have heard anything about that.
See, I was waiting for you to say, what does that have to do with wrestling?
At the same time, what does that have to do with wrestling?
Everything. Because apparently, there's a possibility Raw could be ending up on a Fox show.
Oh, yeah, that's true. So it could be something that Disney owns.
Or distributes.
Yeah.
In a sense. But, so... I turned it around.
All right. You saved yourself on that one.
I just wanted to mention it because I think it's awesome. But at the same time, just fuck with you.
Yeah. So NXT got its cable television debut this past week.
Let's make that clear. Re-debut as an actual wrestling show, not a stupid reality TV show.
Well, contest.
Which was when it was on Sci-Fi.
And it was, what was it, Wednesday?
Wednesday at 7 o'clock.
7 o'clock. So 1 hour show.
Yep.
Got an 840,000 draw.
That's good.
Yeah. I mean, at the same time, you put in Raw and SmackDown, which everyone knows is on Monday night and Tuesday night at the exact same time, and it's been, it's a staple.
Yep.
2.48 and 2.8. Raw got like close to the 2.8. SmackDown was a 2.48.
And then we had Tribute to the Troops on Thursday night.
Yep. I have no idea how well that did.
It's Tribute to the Troops. It doesn't really get that. It gets enough ratings to
warrant doing another one.
To keep doing it, but that's about it.
Yeah. Okay.
So, and not to say downgrade what the show's meant for, but let's be honest, it doesn't get.
No, I mean, it's meant to be a one-off show.
Yeah.
You know, I kind of wish that they had decided to put, I don't know, Starcade, aired that on television instead. But Tribute to the Troops, okay, fine, we'll do it.
Yeah. So it'll be, that was surprising. I mean, and the funny thing is, it was on at 7.
Yeah.
Not even at 8, it was on at 7.
7 o'clock.
So I remember turning, looking up at work and saying, oh, that's right, it's tonight, they're doing it tonight. There it is.
Like, what time is it? Oh. Oh, yeah, it's
like,
almost
that's
over.
Right. It is 7 o'clock. No, I looked at right around 7. I'm like, oh, it's during at 7 instead of 8. Oh, okay, I get that.
Yeah, then, that's still really early.
Yeah. But clearly it was a good time because of the ratings. It's
still almost got 1 million people to watch.
Especially for people who, you only hear NXT mentioned when a person debuts.
Yes.
From NXT. So, because the main roster doesn't really talk about it because, in Vince's mind, he wants to make everyone know that NXT, yes, it exists in the WWE universe. It's not an official...
It's in the dark corners.
Yeah. It's like the main brand, Raw and SmackDown, are the brands.
Yeah.
They're better. That.
But Raw's more betterest.
The more betterest than SmackDown is. But, yeah. So, but that's...
Whatever.
But no. And they had 4 matches, you were saying?
Yes. No match went over 7 minutes.
Which happens sometimes.
One of them was barely over a minute.
That does happen on SmackDown, on NXT. Wow, SmackDown.
On SmackDown?
On NXT sometimes. And then other times they'll have one or shorter matches and then like a 20-minute match, depending on what they were doing for the show. So, but
yeah.
It was good. What I saw, the action, the opening match was the new NXT champion, whatever his name is, Amahalis, wrestling for the first time since winning the championship,
yes.
Which looked like a good match, a decent match. And then Adam Cole lost to, what's his name? Aleister Black.
Yes.
In the main event, I believe.
Yeah, I believe so. That's the one that went 7 minutes, by the way.
There was a few matches, other matches. There was a match that was recorded that was only aired on the network where Ember Moon defeated Peyton Royce.
Right.
And I think there was one other smaller match, but I don't know. But so not everything for the full episode aired on television because you had to make room for the commercials.
Right.
So, but that's still good numbers
for the
first time, especially at this time of year.
Yeah. Dude. I do actually have a Christmas present for you.
You know how I feel about Christmas, Adam.
I know, but
I love it. No,
you're gonna really, really like the. It's gonna come to you on Christmas Day, but I'm gonna spoil it for you now.
Like everything else. Like I spoiled Star Wars for you.
You son of a bitch. How dare you tell me that Han Solo dies?
I know.
Yeah, you ruined everything for me.
He dies again. That's right.
And they dig him up just to die, kill him again.
Yep.
Oh no! No, not that. No,
Kylo Ren figured out a way to kill ghosts for a Force ghost.
Whoa! You're getting John Cena for Christmas. Raw episode.
Just keep him. I don't want him.
No, what? John Cena is the greatest. You know what? He's a good draw. He's able to sell tickets. That's why they're hyping up his return to Raw on Christmas Day.
Because they're clearly having problems selling tickets as Roman Reigns being the main attraction.
Yeah, I mean, you could any day they'd have tough time selling tickets with Roman as the main attraction. But it's Christmas Day on top of it.
Yeah.
Who's going to a wrestling event on Christmas Day other than the most hardcore of hardcore people?
Non-Christians.
Yeah, maybe. I mean, I wouldn't, even if it was just down the street from us, like there's a house show happening in Manchester tonight.
Which is not just down the road from us.
It's a hop, skip, and a jump away.
It's an hour away.
No, it's not. Not from here.
You sure about that?
Yeah.
You sure?
Yeah, it's a 40-minute drive at most.
You sure?
Yeah.
Positive?
Yeah.
Okay. You live around here longer than I have.
Yeah. Hopping over to 101 is a short trip. It's a 15-minute drive over to 101. From here to 101, it's probably another half hour at most.
Okay.
Yeah.
See how much I know.
Now the parking and finding a place to park, that's where the hour comes in.
That's the extra 15 minutes come in?
Yeah. Okay. Easily. Okay. Easily.
That's good to know.
Yeah.
But yeah, that's the reason why they're bringing him back for that.
Yeah, WWE's doing a house show just over there tonight.
Yeah. Is it SmackDown or Raw? Do you know?
I don't remember.
But
there was talk. Oh, it's got to be a Raw because there was talk of The Miz being there.
Oh, okay.
A couple of guys at work have tickets and were excited. And I was
cool.
Yeah, that's cool, guys. Don't invite the guy who's got a podcast about pro wrestling or anything.
go back in there. We're from a wrestling podcast. Can we interview someone?
You know that immediately we'd get kicked out.
Exactly.
It's just not. We would. They'd be like, "Yeah, no, both of you get out of here."
Triple H check walks to the door.
You, the tall one, walk the other way. You, the fatty, walk the other way. And I'd be like, "Not that fat. I've lost weight."
And I'd be like, "Yeah, you are."
Shut up. I've lost weight.
Well, Triple H would come to the back door and it's like, "Guys, I'd love for you to." But the orders came down from Vince. No. You're not even allowed. Your tickets? It's like, raise them up.
Wow, okay.
Thanks. We're very aware of you guys.
Oh, yeah. Totally forgot. You got the office bugged.
Yeah.
He's like, yes, we do.
He's like, so you lost your tickets. Like, all that means is we're just going to bash you a little bit more. That's all.
He's like, yeah, that's cool, but whatever. Get out of here. And but, like, oh, okay.
So I do have to say something. Like, from the Wrestle Talk channel on YouTube, apparently to one of the main guys on that YouTube channel, feels Roman Reigns is getting over with the fans.
The Shield is getting over with the fans.
Well, he's saying it in a sense, and it's true in a sense.
In a sense.
This is how they're doing it. It's by having him do the Intercontinental Open Challenge, like John Cena did with the U.S. It's allowing him to
like
have
Kurt Angle's done in the past.
Yep. It's allowing him to have the best match of the night. So that's getting him over and showing how much of a good worker he is. What? Yes, in a way, he's having the best match of the night because you're putting him in a match with Cesaro.
Yeah.
You're putting him in with people there. I'm not denying that Roman Reigns can be fed through a good match. He has to meet his part.
Yeah.
And as we keep going, he does get better at filling his part. But not every part. Sometimes he gets a really good spot. Like, he hits a lot of stuff dead on. But you know he... It's being crafted in a way to make him look good.
Yeah.
And yes, it's getting him over, but it's more over as because he's part of the Shield. When he breaks off from the Shield, he is going to get massively booed.
Oh, yeah.
Now, here's the one thing I've changed my mind because
outside of his part in the Shield and his part in these other matches, he's a boring character.
Yeah.
There is no... He's not like Naito, who doesn't care.
Yeah.
He's not like John Cena, who's all about the fans.
Yeah.
He's not... There's no driving force.
See, what...
He's not a heel, so he's not wanting to screw other people over.
Yeah.
He's not really a face, because he doesn't seem to actually want anything.
Because... Other than the Universal Championship.
Yeah.
But at the same time...
And even then, I'm like, yeah, just want it because it's there. That's how it feels.
And the other thing is, it's like he doesn't feel like he has to prove himself to anyone. Like John Cena.
Yeah.
Because he's Roman Reigns. He retired the No. But one thing I've changed my mind on.
Okay.
And because this is not going to happen. But if Vince was smart, he would do this because he would... get what he would want for a little while.
Probably.
No, I guarantee you, because we're seeing it now. Keep what you're doing now after Reigns wins the Universal Champion. Meaning, don't split the Shield up.
Yes.
If you kept the Shield together and put him in the main event at WrestleMania, and he won the belt that way, as part of the Shield still.
But the Shield's out back. They're not
on the ringside, but they're part of it. And you wanted to keep the Shields with baby faces. That's fine with me, because at least he's part of the dynamic, and you could put the tag belts back on Seth and Ambrose, and that would be, you had that, what you kind of had the opposite playoff when they first came up. Ambrose had the U.S. title, Reigns and Seth had the tag titles. Now it's kind of changed a little bit, but
yeah.
They were being, when they first got booked, they were booking like main event level, and they got knocked down a little bit because obviously they had to... They were still new. They were
right.
Proved themselves over a long haul, but now it's kind of reflecting where they've come from, and that would help all three of them out instead of Reigns going off to the Universal Championship stuff, Seth and Ambrose feuding again. Ambrose is probably the one who turns heel.
No, the best way to do
and
it.
And then once that feud's over, they're kind of just lost in the crowd again.
Yeah, the best way to do it would be, you know, to have. There's a match for a number one contender shot post WrestleMania.
Yep.
And it's a multi-man match. Both Ambrose and
Seth
get in there.
Yep.
During that match is where you have the breakdown of their team.
No. I'm not saying.
Then one of them wins.
Yep.
And they have to challenge Roman for the title, which breaks that team. But, you know, it's one of those that it's an organic breaking.
Yeah.
It's not meant to be a shock moment.
Yeah.
It's just a slow build.
But doing that to me, makes me go boo. Keeping the Shield together.
Well, that
into
but
WrestleMania and then after WrestleMania, I mean, do you have to keep them together for another like a full make it a full year term by the time they reunited?
Okay.
We get a full year of a babyface run as the Shield, and then they kind of start going their own ways. Maybe like Seth gets traded to SmackDown,
something like that,
or both of them. At least we have that little. They're broken up, but they were only broken up because of a switch.
Yes.
When at joint pay per views, you could see them together, and they're still that team. You get a different way of breaking them up. Yes, I was still going to make me go boo, because no matter what,
I thought you were booing the Shield concept overall, and I was like,
No.
You're going to still boo Roman, because...
Once you take Reigns out of the Shield, I'm going boo unless he's a heel.
Well, the worst...
I'm sorry.
For me, you look at the three of them separately.
Yep.
Ambrose, charismatic. Dude's a little wild.
Yep.
Rollins, charismatic. He's a natural leader.
Yep.
Then you have Roman, he's the brawler.
Yep.
And brawlers aren't, unless they're good on the mic, a la Stone Cold.
Yep.
You don't have, or they have a very good air about them.
Yep.
Undertaker.
Yep.
Roman doesn't have either one of those things.
Well, I will say, because I agree with, I can't remember who I said.
So, like, why is he an interesting character?
He's not.
Why should anyone pay attention to him?
One thing.
No one should.
One they said on the Wrestle Talk podcast, the guy was saying, like, what they did this week with the opening segment was you kind of saw Joe talk trash about Reigns, calling him out, and then you see Reigns in the background there, and then he finally makes it out to the ring. Doesn't cut a promo and just basically beats a badass and attacks Joe, and you get these two brawl. That works for Reigns.
Yes.
If you keep him off the mic, trying to be like the cool guy or like what he was doing, trying to do word for word for it was Cena.
Yeah.
And you do what they did when he beat The Undertaker. Simple promos.
Yeah.
My yard now. Drop the mic. Leave. Stuff like that. If you start putting these pieces together, you can finally get that, find that piece of where he is.
Yeah.
When he talks when he just has something simple to say. After that, he doesn't care how people react. Once I say it, I'm done. I'll wait for you to boom. Like, if you want to boom, like, he just said every time he kind of teased you.
Yeah.
Like, stuff like that. That's fine. But when you're calling him out, he's not picking up the mic to go word to word for you. You called me out, we're fighting.
He's going
to
beat you up.
We're not doing John Cena who will come out and run a promo, then attack you.
Nope.
No, he is the guy. You call him out, we're brawling the second I get in that ring.
So treat him like a Brock Lesnar type character then?
Think of it this way.
Without the mouthpiece?
That, and if you're going to split him off into a separate thing, giving him a mouthpiece wouldn't be a bad thing.
Give him Enzo for no apparent reason.
Brock Lesnar, think of it this way. Take it like Brock Lesnar, Stone Cold Steve Austin, and a Rock all kind of rolled in one without the talking piece.
Yeah.
There. As in how he portrays himself.
Yes. He should be way better. I should be looking at him going, damn, a lot more. But it's blunder after blunder. Just one small stupid thing after another that I'm just like, you guys are trying way too hard with this guy.
Yeah. But so
hopefully they take a softer approach to putting him over next year.
We'll see.
The problem is we know that the Raw following WrestleMania is going to open the same way this year did.
Yeah.
With everyone booing and Roman in the middle of the ring.
Yep.
Only this time he's going to have the universal belt on him.
Yep. So we'll see.
I say put Heyman with him immediately following WrestleMania.
I would say too.
Like there's a Heyman double crosses Lesnar during the match, and therefore Roman becomes a Heyman guy, becomes a heel.
Yep.
But you don't have to have him act like a heel. Yeah. You have Heyman for that.
Yep.
Roman's job is just to come out and fight.
Yeah.
That's it. And that's how you treat him from then on.
Yeah, but we won't. All right, any other news we have in there?
We got the hype train.
What's the
hype train is getting going for Wrestle Kingdom 12.
That doesn't matter. Let's move on.
Chris Jericho, Kenny Omega.
Not gonna be very good. I'm gonna see it now.
Jericho comes out and attacks him.
Half star match.
Look, I'm not saying that they're gonna have a 5-star fireburn, barn burner, or anything like that, or a slobber knocker. I mean, they might actually. Looking at the two major promos that they've cut for this thing,
yeah,
it does look like it might be more of a. Ooh, it could be vicious.
Yeah,
it looks like it's going to be a fight.
Because it was great. Because like you were saying, during the tag team league tournament finals, Kenny Omega defended the U.S. title.
Yep.
And we got another promo from Jericho.
Oh, that was brilliant. You know, video pops right up on the screen. You know, Jericho is just being like, look, you are not where you think you are. Because, you know, before that, Omega was always talking about no one in WWE is on his level.
Yeah.
So, like, Jericho's like, son, I'm going to knock you down a few levels.
Yeah.
You don't know where your level actually is.
And then the lights come up and
Jericho's right there.
And attacks him. Busts him open.
Yes. Now, I do have to say, Omega needs to learn to take the Codebreaker or sell the Codebreaker a lot better.
I think when it comes to the match, we'll get it.
Yes.
They had an angle, the way they were going with the story for the attack.
You know, that weird thing is, it's the first time that Chris Jericho has showed up in a New Japan Pro Wrestling ring.
In a very long
before,
time.
No. Before that, he was under another name under a mask.
Oh, yeah.
The
that's
first
right.
time that Chris Jericho has shown up in a ring.
Oh, yeah.
Which is when it was announced that it was Chris Jericho's debut in New Japan, a lot of people were like, no. He wrestled in Japan. He wrestled in the organization. Yeah, it was just like, he didn't wrestle as Chris Jericho.
Yep.
I forget who he was.
Yeah.
Tiger Mask 19.
Yeah. So.
The one that wears the lizard mask. That was his entire name.
And they were like. The one that wears the lizard mask.
Yeah.
Great.
But it starts off Tiger Mask 19. Like when he gets called to the ring, it's Tiger Mask 19.
He's the 19th person to be in that mask.
Wait for it. The one who wears the lizard mask under the Hello Kitty mask. You're like, how many masks is this guy wearing? Come on.
So.
Who wears blue? You're like. Weighing in at 230 pounds.
Yeah. So.
Who's now wrestling in the right corner.
Like, you guys think right here.
What's. Oh, sorry.
Shut up.
That joke went on a lot longer than necessary.
Yeah, it really did. But Kenny Omega got some blows in.
Yes.
The following night.
Yes.
Tell us about it.
That one, so it was at a press conference.
Yes.
Which, oh my God. A wrestling promotion doing a press conference?
Yeah, exactly.
About an upcoming thing? What is that?
Yeah. And using it for a storyline?
Oh my God. What?
Yeah.
It's like kayfabe is real over there. And they actually realize that at the same time, kayfabe is dead because of social media.
Yeah.
So they incorporate both of it into making this wonderful hybrid.
Yeah.
Which we've seen WWE use before.
But doesn't seem to
harness it completely.
No, I think it's more of a doesn't care to use it on a regular basis because it'd be too much work.
Well, yeah. And, yeah, whatever.
So what happened at this interview?
Kenny Omega came out of, like, he pulled a Randy Orton and came out of nowhere.
Yeah,
and
he
just
did.
Dove, like. Suicide dove over a table at Chris Jericho and just started laying into him.
Yep.
They went back and forth, got separated, came back together, got separated again.
See, I love
Jericho. Jericho threw someone's luggage. It was a wild scene.
I loved how Kenny Omega had a bandage on his head.
His head was bandaged. Not very well, but he was bandaged.
It was like, okay. All right. I was busted open. I had to have a bandage on.
Yeah.
Okay.
It's for me. It's like the rib tape.
Yeah.
That some guys would have just over their bellies, and I'm like, that's not rib tape.
That's not
rib. You'd be taped up a lot higher.
Yep.
It would be up in the armpits. Come on, guys.
That's more hip tape. Than anything in sometimes.
He's wearing a girdle, isn't he? This is to hide the fact that he has a hernia right now. Okay. Yep. Got it.
Exactly. So that draws some interest. It'll be interesting to see how overall that match goes.
Because, they're going to be... It's for the U.S. title, the IWGP U.S. title. So it's awesome. I love the fact that it's also called the IWGP United States Heavyweight Championship, which leaves the possibility of a junior weight... junior weight or just juniors?
Let's find out. Looks like I have a magical device.
Junior heavyweight title. Yeah. Because that's being defended in what's actually a pretty awesome match. Yeah, we're going to be talking more about this overall.
When we come back from our Christmas break.
No, right before it. We're going to give our predictions. We're going to do our predictions for this show 2 weeks early.
Wow.
Which means that I doubt anything is going to change on the card.
Yeah. It is on the Junior Heavyweight Championship.
Yes.
So there could be a Junior United States.
Exactly.
Heavyweight Championship.
Exactly.
If they wanted to.
It looks.
But
you could put it on Ricochet.
That'd be a lot of championships for New Japan.
I know. But they do a very good job of
Yes.
keeping everything very fresh.
And still have non-championship matches mean something on their big pay-per-views.
Well, because wins mean something
not
there.
Not just that.
Getting over with the crowd naturally means something.
Not just that, but it also, like, these big shows are, like, 6 hours long.
Yes, that's also true.
That's why they can do it.
And they have massive tournaments. Mm. The G1 Climax was 18-plus days.
Yep.
So, yeah.
The tag league tournament was, I don't know how many days.
It was at least a week.
No,
straight.
I think it was about 2 weeks.
Okay. Maybe, yeah, because it's been talked about for about 2 weeks now. Yeah, I can't wait. I cannot wait for that one. But that's it. That's all I got for news.
Yeah, I don't have anything really. Other than Enzo Amore's signature on his license is apparently pissing off Maryland.
Well, when you put a Delaware. Dick and balls up as your, your signature, a lot of people are going to be like, dude, do you even know how to write?
Can you read?
Are you actually the softest man in the room?
Yeah, I'm sorry. That does not look like an E and an A. Like he says it does to him.
If it is, then it's connected, then the A is upside down or the E is written wrong. Instead, it literally looks like he doesn't know how to write EA.
Yeah. Come on.
And plus, EA would sue him.
Yeah, exactly. Because EA Sports. Come on.
And EA this and EA everything.
Yeah. Come on.
They're already trying to be the worst video game company in 2017 and 2018. They're already terrible for upcoming releases.
I thought they were actually doing better over the last few years.
Monetarily, they're doing great. But just the shit that they're doing to people.
Oh, okay. That thing. Okay.
Pay to play for Battlefield 2. Sorry, not Battlefield. Battlefront, Star Wars Battlefront 2. Yep. Yeah, you could either pay, it was something close to $2,000 to unlock everything, or play through, and it would take, what'd they say? It works out to be 24 straight days of gameplay.
Wow, to be able to unlock it?
To unlock everything.
Wow.
24 days.
So that means you're getting your money worth if you're playing through stuff, but...
But that's being the best.
Yeah.
That's the fastest amount of time.
Yeah, exactly.
That someone like me would unlock in, I don't know, a year and a half of playing the game, while somebody who decides that they've got money have everything right away. And I'd be like, thanks. Cool. Yay. Or you can win these chests and pay them something like $2 for a key to unlock it. I'm like, no, I play games that do that already. And I'm like, I'm not paying for it. Yeah. Sorry. You're not giving me a product good enough for me to pay for these loot boxes. Now, great game. That is doing a pay to play type of situation.
Yep.
They understand the microtransaction situation. Fortnite, their battle royale game.
Interesting.
You can unlock a bunch of stuff. It's all cosmetic. Doesn't do anything extra for you in the game.
That's cool.
That's all. And I'm like, those are microtransactions that I'm willing to pay for.
That's cool.
Yeah.
All right.
Sorry. Had to go off on that rant for a second of EA.
Well, because you don't have, what's that one you guys usually go off on? Is that Geek News or?
Oh, yeah. Last Week's Geek.
Last Week's Geek. That's the one.
It's been a while. I don't normally get angry during that show, though.
I'm just saying, you haven't done it. That's why. You haven't done one in a while.
Getting angry.
You got all this stuff is building up.
I know.
You and Remy are going to have to finally at least do one for Star Wars.
I would hope so.
I mean, come on.
Anyway.
No, I know what you're. Yeah. I know the reason why you're going to do one soon. You're going to do one because you have to do a movie review for Pitch Perfect 3.
I want you to slap yourself for saying that. Thank you. Anyway, moving on. Let's get some predictions out of the way. You know what? Ring of Honor first.
Yeah, of course.
Let's get the final battle. The final battle.
So let's make this clear. Why we are predicting this, because by the time this thing gets uploaded, the show will be over. It is tonight as we're doing this recording. But this is not actually going to count towards our...
Nope, this one's for fun.
This is fun. Though...
Eventually.
Eventually, we'll... test it out, maybe see if we can do that. but the Wrestle Kingdom 12 will count.
Yes, it will.
Which could really screw me over in the long run.
Eight correct predictions behind you right now for the year.
And after this pay-per-view coming up Sunday, that might be even larger.
Nope. I'm not getting crazy with my picks this time.
I hope not, because it's a nothing pay-per-view.
I am going safe all the way.
You go safe all the way. All wrong.
I know.
Princess is like, we're going to screw with everyone.
Wait. Why did you bring Russo back? Yeah. What's with the swerve?
Yeah. Okay.
All right. So Ring of Honor.
I'm just going to read them off based on what they have on Wikipedia. Did you write this down?
Yes, I did.
Okay. So according to Wikipedia, match number 8 is the Hun Bucks, Adam Page, Matt Jackson, and Nick Jackson. Versus
it's Hangman Page and the Jacksons.
Or Adam Page, it says on here.
Well, that his nickname was Hangman.
Versus Dragon Lee, Flip Gordon, and Titan.
Yeah, we're going with Titan on that one.
Yeah.
I don't know how to pronounce that little funky thing over the A.
Yep.
Titan?
For the Ring of Honor.
Man, that was terrible.
World 6-Man Tag Championship.
Yes.
That's the first one. Adam, since you're more the independent guy, let's have you start us off.
I'm saying it's staying on the young. It's staying with the Young Bucks.
It's the Hung Bucks.
I know, but like.
I know.
The Bullet Club is so over right now that it's kind of, unless they're going to, I don't see Ring of Honor taking the titles away from Bullet Club to put it on other people with this close to Wrestle Kingdom.
Yeah.
Because of the two organizations working together.
Yeah.
I say they'll be left on them for a little while.
Yep. I agree. I'm going to pick them, too.
Okay.
All right. So, number 7.
That was weird. I mean, that was odd that we just totally agreed on that one.
I know, but it makes sense. So, the next matchup is...
Yes.
The Motor City Machine Guns.
God, I'm glad they're back. And they're still around.
Alex Shelley and Chris Sabin versus Best Friends Beretta and Chucky T for the tag team... Ring of Honor Championship, World Tag Team Championship.
Yes.
The Motor City Machine Guns are the champions.
Yes, they are.
So, I'm going to go with Motor City Machine Guns. I think they're going to retain.
You know what? In that case, I'm going the Best Friends for no apparent reason other than to disagree with you on this one.
Okay.
Because...
Which is going to tear you apart because you wanted the Motor City Machine Guns.
God damn you, I did.
Yeah, that's me. That's why I'm the heel of this group.
Because that was my...
I know. But I honestly think they're going to win, though.
I know.
See, that's why I let you pick the first one, so I could pick the Motor City Machine Guns. So,
all right.
Just so I could fuck with you.
Well, I get the next one.
That's fine. The next matchup is Matt Taven versus Will Ospreay.
You know what's really sad is I wrote down Matt Maven. It's a T, not an M.
Maven retired a while ago.
Yeah, I know. I'm picking Will Ospreay for this one.
That's funny because I was going to do that too.
Okay.
But just for the fun of it, I'll go with Matt Taven.
Okay.
Just for the fun of it.
Now, Will Ospreay, I just... Right now, the dude is having an amazing 2017.
Yeah, he is.
He is definitely like on our short list for best of the year.
Speak for yourself. Don't say ours because you don't know who's on my top 10.
Oh, and I'm not saying top 10. I'm having like breakout year.
Don't even say that for us because you have no clue.
Oh, okay.
Because I only
is there somebody in PWG that you suddenly were like, this guy?
Because I only pick WWE stars because they're the only people that matter.
So what, Jason Jordan had the breakout of the year?
Absolutely.
It's Roman Reigns again.
Yes, it is.
John Cena, rookie of the year.
Exactly.
You're like, how is he getting rookie? Well, when they come back, it's the start of it all over again.
Yep, exactly. Roman Reigns is winning everything this year for me.
Of course he is.
Because you know my love of Roman Reigns.
It goes deep.
Yeah,
it does. Real deep. Enzo Amore's signature deep.
Yeah, exactly. Okay. So the next matchup
that's gonna be a joke for a long time.
Yeah, it is. That's how low the bar goes.
The bar.
insults. Enzo Amore's signature deep.
Yep.
So the next matchup is The Addiction, Christopher Daniels and Frankie Kazarian.
Legends right there, buddy.
War Machine, Hanson and Raymond Rowe in a tag match.
Yes.
I'm going to pick...
Yeah.
I was going to go with Addiction, but I think I'm going to go with War Machine.
Okay.
Any particular
reason?
No, nah, just when I look at it, like, I was going to go with the no more of those, the first two. But I'm like, I know how they book War Machine is a good team. So I'm just going to go with them.
They've been booked really strong for a while now. Throughout their indies run.
Oh, yeah. So
and Addiction with, you know, Christopher Daniels and Frankie Kazarian being, well, at this point, technically legends.
Yeah.
They're kind of the high mark. They're like, hey, if you can run with us, you know, you can go on to bigger and better things.
Yeah. So it'll be interesting to see what they do with them. I'm going to pick the War Machine.
Yeah, I haven't paid attention to any promos regarding this.
Neither have I.
So, you know what? In that case, I'm going to go with Addiction. We're going to cover our bases. Okay. One of us will get one right.
Okay. I will say a lot of people compare War Machine with... what's their names from WWE? That shows up on...
Ascension?
Yes. Like how to and not to do similar gimmick.
Oh, yeah. Well, I mean, then you now have to also include the Bludgeon Brothers into that gimmick now.
Well, Rowan and Harper are good together.
Yeah.
But it's enough. It's a different enough, I'd say, from what I've seen.
Well, for now.
For now, yeah. But we'll see. But. Okay, the next matchup, I know where you're going with this one.
Oh, really? Do you?
I have a feeling. Is Jay Lethal versus Marty Scurll. But before we do our prediction, Marty Scurll was... Squirrel.
You're going to go with Squirrel. Okay.
He's a squirrel.
You have Ginger Mahal and...
He's Squirrel Boy.
Ginger U-Haul and Squirrel Boy. Okay,
Ginger,
all right.
Ginger U-Haul. Marty Scurll was given the option to face anyone he wanted in Ring of Honor.
Okay.
And he chose Jay Lethal.
I mean, Jay Lethal he's been champion.
Yep.
He's a threat in the ring every time he's in there.
Yes, he is.
And I think that this is going to be a good match.
Oh, by far.
It's just... what kind of Marty Scurll are we going to see here?
Exactly.
Are we going to see the man who has no problem busting out the umbrella halfway through a match just because he wants to hit a guy with it?
Yep.
DQ or not?
Yep.
Or is this because it's Ring of Honor, we're going to see him come out with a little bit more of an honorable match?
We'll see. He is part of the Bullet Club.
Well, I know.
And he is the villain.
Yes, he is the villain.
So... it'll be interesting to see.
I've seen his stuff over on, sorry, not WCPW anymore, Defiant Wrestling.
Who's that again?
What? Really?
Yeah, I went
Stu
there.
Bennett. You know, he's the GM.
Who's that? It's not
Wade Barrett.
It's not WWE. I don't care.
Damn it. Yeah, so, you know what? I'm taking Jay Lethal on this one.
You are.
I am taking Jay Lethal.
You just wanted to prove me wrong. That's why.
No, I was taking Jay Lethal the moment that I saw that Jay Lethal's name was on here.
Sure you did. I'm going with Marty Scurll.
Okay. All right.
Marty Scurll. Don't get that. That's Marty. He knows he has a match in New York. He somehow magically appeared.
I wrote down Marty Scurll for you.
Okay, thank you. Okay, so the next matchup is for the Ring of Honor World Television Championship.
Okay. All right.
Champion Kenny King defending against Punishment Martinez versus Shane Taylor versus Salas Young.
I don't know who any of these people are.
Kenny King was one of the members of season 3, I believe, of Tough Enough. No. Was it Tough Enough 3?
I'm going to be honest.
I think it was Tough Enough 2.
You couldn't tell me pretty much anyone out in there at all. And I'd be like, yeah, they were there. Cool.
Yeah. But he got to start in Tough Enough, one of the original Tough Enough shows. And made himself of something, though, which is good.
Yeah.
So, but...
I mean, not everyone can be The Miz who goes on MTV, says that he's going to become a WWE wrestler,
yeah,
and actually makes it happen. Not everyone can do that.
Yeah, no. And be able to lose Tough Enough only to become the world champion, where yeah, no Tough Enough winner has ever done that.
I know. That is so weird.
So
I think they should bring back Tough Enough, though.
They have to revamp it. Oh, greatly, yeah.
But I'd still keep it as a competition where they can get cut at the end of the day type of thing. But instead of being like, oh, here's a run up the hill challenge or any, it's not a, you know, reality show that's in their house or anything like that. No, it's them literally training. And at the end of the day, they go, you didn't do good enough today, kid. Sorry, you're cut.
See, what I would do is I would basically copy and paste the Ultimate Fighter format.
Except get rid of the house.
Get rid of the house. Well, no, do like a house.
No.
But you're not doing people. This is not for people who've never been trained.
Right.
This would be independent stars earning their contract. Not someone who's already had their contract, who's trying, gives up their contract, like some people did in the 2011 to be in Tough Enough.
Yeah.
Which is dumb. People from the independent scene who've already trained, you bring them in, you put them in a house. Because that part of the thing is you're working, you still have to work together, mind frame, no teams or anything like that. But you're seeing them train, and at the end of the, you have two teams.
Yep.
Coaches, all that stuff still. And you pick matchups to have a wrestling matchup.
Oh, yeah.
And the judges, if you lose the match, it's not that you lose. You're eliminated.
It's about putting on the match.
It's about taking what you've learned in your training and applying that, and the judges evaluate that.
Right.
And based on that, the loser could win.
Oh yeah, he could be the match winner, but still end up losing.
But I don't think WWE would ever do that because it's too much pulling the curtain back on that stuff. But
it would be perfect.
I think it would be great.
It'd be awesome. Anyway.
So when they announce Tough Enough in a few weeks,
and
they say that's exactly what they're going to be doing, we know we're
bugged. We're still bugged. I thought I swept the room. I really did.
Using a broom and from your chair is not kind of actually sweeping the room.
Oh, it's not?
No.
Oh, okay.
Okay.
It got the cobwebs. Did get a couple of bugs.
Yeah, not the kind of bug we're looking for.
Oh.
We're looking for a microphone, a tiny microphone.
They're right here in front of us.
One that's hidden.
Oh, like the one under the table?
That's one under the table?
Yeah, it's been there for a while.
Oh, okay. Mystery solved.
Yeah, done. There's one over there on the entertainment center, too. So there's two of the... we found them. We found the bugs.
Sure we did.
All right.
Someone got lazy in WWE.
Kenny King, Punishment Martinez, yes. Shane Taylor, or Silas Young. Who are you taking?
Other than Kenny King, I don't know who any of these are. Okay. I've heard the name Punishment Martinez. By the way, it's a four-way elimination match.
Yes.
I forgot. But I'm going to go with Kenny King.
Okay.
Because, honestly, I think he just won it not that long ago, too. So,
Hold on. We're going to go Shane Taylor.
Okay. Why? You like the name Shane, don't you?
You know what? It's better than Silas.
Okay.
So there. Haha. All right. So, now, next up, we have Bully Ray and Tommy Dreamer versus...
This is my job.
Oh, sorry. I'm sorry.
This is...
I got the next show then.
Yes, exactly. Okay.
All right. Sorry.
Because I don't really care for that. No. No. Bully Ray and Tommy Dreamer versus the Briscoes in a New York City street fight. Who are you going to pick?
I'm taking the Briscoes.
You're taking the Briscoes?
I'm taking the Briscoes.
I was going to take the Briscoes. I guess I like Tommy. Nope, I'm taking Briscoes. Sorry. I'm not going to do that.
I don't blame you. The reason I'm taking the Briscoes is simply this is the old guys, one kind of having a retirement match, and they're putting over the Briscoes, who are already a very
established
tag team, yep. especially in Ring of Honor.
Yeah.
But this is giving just a, it's like, hey, you know what? Bully Ray could choose anybody
yep.
to have a retirement match with. Tommy Dreamer could have anybody to have a retirement. Tommy yeah. Dreamer is going to be the dude who's like 73 and still getting in the ring.
So
we know that.
He's the modern day Terry Funk.
Yes.
But in better condition.
Yeah. Surprisingly yeah. better condition. I don't know how he does it.
Neither do I.
These guys are putting over the Briscoes.
Yeah.
They're just like, no. Briscoes, you've just gone from, you know, a superstar in this industry. We're moving you up to legends.
Yeah.
You know, it's like, oh, okay.
We're pushing into that.
Yeah.
On that elevation towards
you,
that.
The Briscoes should, I would love to see the Briscoes have a run with the Young Bucks that not only is in Ring of Honor,
yeah.
but in New Japan as well.
Oh, yeah.
Like, the Briscoes get the tag title, or the Bucks get the tag titles in Ring of Honor. Briscoes take it off from them and then challenge them for the IWGP titles.
Yeah.
So. It'd be like, whoa, what is this? You know, something like that.
Yep.
So we're both taking the Briscoes.
Yes. And then in the main event for the brand new Ring of Honor World Championship belt,
which looks awesome.
Yes, it does. Though I'm kind of disappointed about the Ring of Honor that Cody.
That's Cody's thing.
Yeah. But the brand new belt. That does not say Cody's name on it.
No, it's because it's being awarded to whoever wins this match.
Yeah, it does make it clear. It's not that the title is vacated. It's just the new belt. They didn't want to put his name on it because the match is coming up.
Right. They didn't know who was going to win in the match.
Though they posted
wink, wink, nudge, nudge.
Though they put a picture on Twitter of his name actually on the belt. So.
I think that might not have been smart. Then again, who knows? Okay.
But, so, Dalton Castle.
Yes.
Has been on fire lately.
Dude, he's been sneaking up on Cody and getting, you know, just shots in on him over and over again.
Not just that.
My best one was when Cody was taking selfies with the crowd, and Dalton slid right up next to him and then pulled the mask off. That was awesome.
is that they've been, he's been being built. Like,
yes.
His contract came up a few months ago, and it was rumored that he was going to be signed with WWE. He re-signed with Ring of Honor.
Yeah, I don't see him moving anytime soon.
Which was a sign for something. So, and Cody's had the belt for a while. So,
yeah, it's been about a year?
No.
No, it's less than that.
About 6 months.
Yeah.
So
yeah, because at Dominion, he wasn't the Ring of Honor champ. He would have had the belt then.
He won it right before Dominion.
Oh, okay.
No.
No, it was right after.
Yeah, right after, because he won it, because he had it, he was Ring of Honor champion when he challenged Okada.
Right.
For the IWGP.
Which would have been awesome.
So, yeah, it was right around that time. So, as much as I'm going to take a guess that Cody will win this, I am going to pick Dalton Castle to be the new Ring of Honor champion.
Okay. It could be a moment that Dalton gets the belt put on him.
Yep.
It could be passing of the guard because, I mean, it was before Cody, it was
Christopher Daniels. Yep.
And it was just like, nope, Christopher is like, it's your time, kid, type yep. of thing. Is this the time to put it on Dalton? Maybe. Personally, I'm saying it's staying on Cody.
Oh, so do I. I think
it's going to be next year.
Sometime, yeah.
That Cody finally drops it. It's going to be 2018 at some point.
I think so too, but I'm just going to go. If you're going to change it anytime soon, this would be the guy they're going to put it on.
Yeah.
As a first time run to see how it goes. But
they don't. But they don't. Ring of Honor doesn't really do the see how it goes.
Well, that's what I mean. Like as it goes, like they know if they put it on him, he's going to be fine. Because you don't get a match in Ring of Honor for the world title unless they know you're good.
Yeah, yeah, that's true.
So, because I think it was this time last year, Dalton Castle was the television champion.
Yes.
I believe. And then he won the six-man tag. He championed with the boys, Dalton Castle and the boys. And now he's challenging for the world champion. So, I don't know. We'll see. But now on to the important pay-per-view. A WWE pay-per-view.
Sorry, what? Wasn't paying attention. I'm looking at this timer of how long Luke was silent at the end of The Force Awakens. We're at 33 seconds. Yeah, it was 33 seconds of him just being silent while Rey held out the lightsaber to him. Dude was rude.
Yeah, he was.
Wow. I don't know. You walk up to me holding anything. It was just like held it out to me, and I just stood there for 30 seconds. At some point, you're just going to drop it and be like, seriously, say something.
And then and the audacity in the new one to just smack her what across the face.
No! Don't you dare. Anyway.
I've already spoiled it for you, remember?
Let's go ahead and get into Clash of Champions. Everyone dies. Yes, everyone dies. No, that was Rogue One.
I know. See, that would have been a great one to tell everyone to ruin it for them. Everyone dies. Ha 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 ha. Fuck you, dude. Fuck you.
All right. So we have, on the pre-show, Zack Ryder versus Mojo Rawley. The hype bros have been hyped out, and now they got to go again. So Zack Ryder is facing his imaginary friend in the ring. How well is Zack Ryder going to be able to sell being in the ring by himself?
Well, obviously, WWE has faith in him to do it because they are putting a match on
it. I know.
Yes,
The pre-show.
It is the pre-show, but still, if they didn't think he could do it, he wouldn't even have a match.
It would be a dark match someplace on a house show.
Exactly. So clearly,
20 minutes after the show ends, as the crowd is almost completely out the door, Zack Ryder's music hits.
Woo, 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 woo.
And they're like, ah.
You know it.
But it's 11 o'clock. I'm going to go to bed.
Yeah, I'm going to go. Yeah. I don't know how I know his music and just like, woo 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 woo, you know it. Oh, radio.
Oh, okay.
So yes, and the ironically thing, they were teasing a Zack Ryder heel turn, and it was Mojo Rawley who turned heel.
Yep.
So I'm going to go with...
Who do you have and why?
I'm going to go with Mojo Rawley.
Okay.
Because this is clearly a vehicle for him to try to get him a little bit more, to maybe make him somewhat relevant.
Yes.
But, yeah, I'm going to go with Mojo
Rawley. It does feel like this is the precursor to the possibility of a probable push.
Yeah.
This is Braun Strowman 2 years ago.
Yeah.
Really?
Yeah.
Or just over a year ago.
I mean, he won the Andre the Giant Battle Royal.
Yeah. So has the Big Show twice, okay? So
he won it once.
Oh, he won it once. So has the Big Show, and they didn't do anything there other than turn him heel or turn him face again. I don't know.
That was more of an honorary of him actually winning a Battle Royal once.
I know.
And where Andre never lost a Battle Royal.
Yeah.
Because of his son. So...
Yeah, okay. So we're both choosing Mojo.
Mm-hmm.
Because we're getting our Mojo on. We're the man who's not there. He's an imaginary friend. Whoa. He's getting the win. That's going to really... You know, Zack Ryder should get a push out of this.
Yes.
Because if he can sell losing...
to nothing.
To his imaginary friend, it's going to be amazing.
Yeah.
It's going to be glorious.
Yay. That is a Bobby Roode.
Sorry, that's going to be safe for later.
Yes.
All right. Next up, we have Breezango versus the Bludgeon Brothers.
I'm going to go with the Bludgeon Brothers.
Yeah, I don't. This is...
See, you don't want to take a chance on Breezango?
Nope, not at all. Yeah. No, because, I mean, lately, the Bludgeon Brothers have been booked very strong.
Destroying talent.
I'm being... sarcastic when I say very.
I know.
It's so strong. Like, Roman Reigns is looking over there going, hold on.
Hey.
I thought I was the only one supposed to be booked this strongly.
You're like, hey, Vince, you're not supposed to book anyone stronger than me.
Yeah.
He's like, and Vince is just like.
Vince is like, new phone, who dis?
Who this? Oh, Reigns? You're old news, dude.
And even better, Reigns is like, I'm yelling at you from across the room.
He's like,
shut up.
He's like, Your old, he's a text like, your old news, dude. Go fuck yourself. And he's like, he goes, Vince, why'd you say that? And he's like, I didn't say that. I lost my phone.
Yeah.
Triple H is in the back.
Triple H is over there on the side. Like, fuck you.
Fuck you. Like, let's get on the, you're fired.
Quick, fire him.
Fire him. Fire him. He's going to talk to him.
Yeah, we're Bludgeon Brothers have been looking real, like, It also makes me realize just how good Luke Harper truly is.
Yeah.
Like, I'm just like, damn, this guy can move in the ring.
Get rid of that stupid crucifix double team.
Yeah, sure. Give them something else.
I'm sorry. When you have people as strong as Cesaro and Sheamus doing that, and they struggle to do it at times.
Yeah. No. The better one?
Yeah.
The electric chair. They straight up, oh God, I'm blanking on the tag team.
You mean Legion of Doom?
Yes, they straight up just take that.
That would work.
Yeah.
Or
a version of the 3D.
No, not the version of the 3D. I think they could.
Yeah, no.
I think they could figure out a way to turn the Doomsday device into their own thing.
Yeah.
These things, you can't be the exact same thing. You have to turn it into your own.
Like, thing. Yeah, something different.
Yeah. Which would really be kind of cool is, like, Rowan picked the guy up on his shoulders, and Harper came off the ropes and jumped and hit him off there. That would be kind of cool.
Oh, yeah.
But that's a high place to jump up to. I think he could probably do it, but...
Well...
Oh, no, it would be kind of fun to see him do.
What?
If, like, Rowan picks him up on there, Harper ran at the ropes. I was like, turn away. Away from the mic.
Oh, yeah.
Came off there and did a second rope springboard clothesline.
Luke Harper could do that. That man can move.
Yep. Jump and then turn into a clothesline.
It's just a basic second rope clothesline.
Yeah, he just comes, he bounces off, turns. As he's turning, Rowan brings him closer enough, and then Harper takes it out.
Yeah.
There you go.
And really, most of it actually would be more Rowan doing an electric chair.
Yeah.
That's all it would be.
Unless they want
to unlike Legion of Doom, where I swear to God, it was... They waited for the clothesline to hit before they made any movement down.
There were some times that they didn't even move.
Yeah, he would just let him go.
Yep.
I was like, oh, that's scary.
Yeah, I think they should do that.
Oh, that's scary.
I mean, obviously you do it with people who can land
right
correctly.
Yeah, yeah.
Because that would make them even look more devastating.
I know.
So.
But you know, WWE has a very safe style.
I don't know what you're talking about.
Soft can be the word.
I don't know what you're talking about. Miz style?
Yeah. All right. Next up, we have Orton and Nakamura versus Owens and Zayn.
This is probably going to be the main event of the night.
Oh, probably.
Mr. McMahon,
Shane's involved.
Mr. McMahon himself is involved. I mean, Shane McMahon, I'm sorry, is involved. Daniel Bryan is involved.
Yep.
If Owens and Zayn lose, they're fired from the WWE.
Yes. That's why I don't think that this would close the show.
No.
This will be like, it'll be towards the end of the card.
No.
This is not going to be the second match of the night.
No, it's not going to be the second match of the night. I do think it
could
be
a show opener.
No, I don't think it would be
okay
with it. They could. I could see that, but they're going to build to Shane coming out.
Okay.
And this basically dominated SmackDown. So I'm more like this is going to be the... And if the Jinder Mahal experiment is truly over, what better way to prove that by putting him the world title in a second to last?
Yeah, I know.
That way would you like...
But well, I prefer to put the championship last.
So do I. But like, it's not because AJ's in the match. It's because we're downgrading Jinder.
Yeah,
and
I mean,
I'm
no matter
Jinder again.
No matter what, I would rather see a belt defended at the end of the show.
So do I.
The belt defended.
Jinder U-Haul.
Yeah.
That U-Haul was your thing.
I know.
And I just took it.
I like it.
So Jinder
U-Haul.
Jinder U-Haul. There, so
dude, I mean, you're probably a pretty cool guy, but you know,
for
we gotta make fun of your character
being Canadian.
Yeah, hey, Canadians are cool, those flappy headed bastards calling everyone buddy and guy and friend.
Hey, you're more than welcome to hang out with me as long as you keep apologizing for everything I do.
Yeah, just say sorry.
Just sorry.
Sorry a lot.
He says he's sorry. No, I'm not. He's really sorry.
Sorry about that.
I told you to say that after I walk away, not while I'm around.
Okay.
Oh, I'm sorry. Stop doing that.
So, what are you calling for this one?
This is a tough one.
Yeah.
Because personally, Nakamura needs a win here.
He does.
But at the same time, that's a potential Daniel Bryan heel turn, which we're probably not going to get.
Now, I don't see Daniel Bryan screwing over Nakamura and Orton, yeah, because he's not if we do get a heel turn,
yeah,
it's going to be Bryan attacking Shane.
Yeah.
And being like, no, I'm putting my foot down on this. Okay, fine. You're going too far. Well, guess what? Here's a yes kick.
Yep.
It'll be something like that.
Yeah. But I'm going to go with this. I mean, if this is the show ender.
Yeah.
The main event, you want a good storyline to keep people paying attention through the holiday season,
right?
Owens and Zayn lose because
wow,
because who you're gonna tune into? Like, wait, you just fired your top talent?
Yeah,
you're gonna turn into why the see what how it happens.
I would, and if you're gonna do that, keep them off for a month. And then have them, break in. Basically pull a Matt Hardy.
See, what I would do to kind of get something in some way, to get them out on the show or something, on WWE Network, on the website or something,
yep,
like that, show them, like, outside the arena being, like, arrested.
Oh.
Trespassing.
Okay.
Or maybe showing a clip on from earlier.
And eventually they kidnap Shane McMahon.
Yes.
And demand that they get back on the show.
Yeah, something like that. But it's not probably going to happen. But I'm going to go with Kevin Owens and Sami Zayn.
Okay. They're winning.
Yeah.
So, I'm going with a no finish.
No finish? Ooh.
No finish. Because there's going to be a moment at the end where Zayn... No, you know what? Owens is pinning Orton.
Mm-hmm.
Nakamura is pinning Zayn. Both refs slide in, count to three at nearly the exact same time, and go and declare their man the winner, their team the winner.
Mm-hmm.
Breaks down. Finally, Triple H has to come out there. And instead...
Pedigree Shane again?
Well, instead of... like, if you know, we get a no finish. Basically, it gets pushed to next Tuesday. And but at that one, Shane is so pissed off by the finish that he bars Owens and Zayn from the show. So they show up on Raw to cut a promo on him the next week. Basically, it keeps this going for one more to the next pay-per-view, yeah, which is
Royal Rumble,
which would not be bad.
Yeah. But okay, you're going with no finish. Interesting.
Yep.
It violates our rules of having to pick an actual winner.
But you can see in this situation that it's either going to be a winner, and Sammy and the story will be that Sammy and Owens have been fired.
But see, the thing is,
there's no finish.
See, the thing is, though, if they're going to do that double pin thing, I can see what happened.
Again?
I see what they're doing is Shane saying no. I recover, because what will happen will be Shane will take a bump where he's out.
Yes.
And then Daniel's being the referee now, and Shane will recover. He'll count that. And he's saying, I recovered, so I'm officially back in the room.
Yeah, there. I'm the lead ref. And you're like, no,
and
we're
Daniel
both.
And Daniel could say, I didn't see you. But no, Daniel's the second ref.
Oh, yeah, yeah.
Outside ring. But
I didn't see that you were recovered.
You didn't come. I didn't see you, and you didn't tell me. So I was still officially the ref.
Something crazy.
That's
stupid
what
they
had to
like
do, because Shane could just say, no, I'm the official ref. They lost, they're fired, and it could lead to Bill, but we'll see.
Yeah. All right. Next up we have the Usos.
Oh wait, that's right.
Yeah.
You could do this
is
one.
I know, I'm sorry. Okay,
you know the funny thing is, I'm the WWE guy and
yeah,
I'm
I know.
The Ring of Honor and you're doing it.
Yeah, I know. Okay, so we got the Usos versus the New Day versus Shelton Benjamin and Chad Gable.
Why are they in the match?
Versus Rusev and Aiden English.
Why are they in the match?
Okay. I said this earlier in the booking room. Somebody was like, can we get the Usos and the New Day? Somebody else in the booking room was like, haven't we done that 9 times already? And they're like, third person in the booking room went, fine, put 2 other teams in there. But not from the you know, tag team division, real, because we can't have anyone look strong in the division right now.
Exactly.
So that's why we have this two, even though Benjamin and Gable have been a team for a little while, they're not a tag team.
No, they are.
Oh, they finally are?
When they brought Shelton in, they are officially a tag team.
Okay. Well, Rusev and Aiden English are not a tag team.
They're building him towards that because, like, from they've been kind of teaming, working together, but now they're kind of like, this is the way they build him into him. So, who knows? So, let's see. I know the betting odds as of today have the Usos retaining.
Yep.
Not by much.
Well, you know, no, because it's a fatal four-way.
No, the funny thing is, the betting odds don't say what the odds are for every team.
Oh.
It's Usos, everyone else, same betting odds.
Wow.
The way it was put on Wrestling Inc. So that was hilarious.
All right.
I know who I want to win this.
Your bae, your spirit animal, Ruru?
No.
Oh. I forgot that I don't sit across from Ross on wrestling.
I want to ruin Rusev Day.
No, not Rusev Day.
Yes.
Rusev Day is greatest day.
No, it's not. I want to ruin Rusev Day and have Shelton Benjamin and Chad Gable win the belts. But I don't see a big change happening here.
I'm sorry, you're trying to put logic into a wrestling thing. That the two best pure wrestlers
I know
would be able to get a win. What?
Yeah, I know. So I'm going to go with the Usos.
Okay.
I'm going to go with the current betting odds.
You know what? I'm breaking the odds on this one.
You're going with New Day?
Yes.
Because you're convinced they're going to be a fight. They got to break the record by WrestleMania.
I swear this is what's going to happen.
I'm surprised.
I
Royal Rumble, they lose it.
Yeah.
Elimination Chamber, they win it back. Raw, SmackDown,
so
they lose it.
It's so sad that that's kind of what might happen.
I know.
Just because Vince wants the New Day to beat the record.
I don't know.
I'm like, you could stretch it out for 2 more years.
Yeah, I know.
Come on. It's like, no, we got to strike while the iron's hot. So they're going to play hot potato with us for the next 6 months.
So, you know, the funny thing is, like, get them, like, right up there, like, to tie the record, like, in over a year.
And then nothing.
And then break them up.
Yep.
And then, like, 3 years, 4 years later, they come back as a group and win the title.
That would be nice.
That would be the way you break it.
Yes.
Actually, me and 7 just hot potato as a team. They came back to break the record.
Or you can John Cena it and just let them sit at it for a long time. Yeah. As still a team, though. All right. Next up, we have Flair versus Hart. It's the battle of the 90s all over again.
But in female form?
Oh, yeah, sorry. It's Charlotte Flair versus Natalya.
Yeah.
Hart.
Well, Neidhart? This is Natalya right now, but it used to be Natalya Hart.
Put the Hart back on there.
It used to be Natalya Neidhart. Now it's Natalya. Who knows? In a lumberjack match.
Lumberjill.
It says lumberjack on Wikipedia. It's a lumberjack.
Don't care.
You can't be sexist. It has to be. Well, it's the same.
In a match for the women's championship.
Can't be sexist.
So it's the not men's championship?
Exactly.
Okay. I mean, we try.
It's the Euro championship.
So it's Flair versus Hart. It actually looks like a very cool match. I just wish that they booked Natalya better.
And I wish that the Riot Squad had a match or
anything
other than being lumberjacks or Jills or
yeah.
non-men in the match.
Yeah, I don't know.
But we'll see. It'd probably be a good match, but we'll see. Flair's retaining.
Yes. Like both of us, yes.
Yes.
We know how this is going to go. Vince Russo would have to be hired for Natalya to suddenly get the win here.
I don't know. If Vince Russo was rehired, somehow
China would come back from the dead and win the championship.
No. Somehow one of the Lumberjills would somehow win the title when they're only Lumberjills, not actually in the match.
Yeah, they're not part of the match in any way.
They're just outside, but somehow they won the title.
One of them wins.
Kind of like how Broomstick fell on someone when they're sleeping and won the Hardcore Championship.
Hey, you know, Moppy was a badass.
That wasn't Moppy.
I know. But Moppy was a badass.
Yes, she was.
All
until
right.
Until Al Snow shredded her.
I know. I feel bad. Al Snow is such a mean dude, man.
Yeah.
He's so terrible. So next up, we have the U.S. title. Baron Corbin versus Bobby Roode, who makes everything glorious. And Dolph Ziggler, who finally actually has a gimmick or entrance music.
Kind of.
Except for when Kevin Dunn decides to cut it off halfway through and then not restart it, just continue on after a period of silence. All right. Do you not know how to work the buttons, man? Your teeth aren't the only things that can control everything. They don't control the universe.
Kevin Dunn does not know how to push a woman's button.
Look, these aren't women's buttons. They're buttons on a board.
Or a men's button.
All right. Well, on paper, this actually looks to be a very good, solid match.
Yes.
Baron Corbin, really, at this moment, his only step up would be to shave his head, cut his hair, go short. I don't care. Give yourself a little bit of a, you know, flat top. I don't spike it.
Yeah.
But get rid of that. Dude, you're balding worse than I am. And I know that I need to go back to a short haircut. Come on. Your hair is way too thick. Shawn Michaels at least wore a hat
most of the time.
And or had it all pulled back, so it kind of covered his bald spot.
Yeah. Yep.
Kind of.
Or in WWE photos, they photoshopped it.
Yeah. Has he cut his hair? I don't remember. Did he cut his hair short?
No.
Oh, okay.
I think so.
Okay.
He wears hats.
Good for him.
He can't.
I'm going to be wearing hats real soon, too.
I don't know why. He should just use road game foam.
Okay.
Please, road game, please sponsor our podcast.
Yeah. Do you want to go first?
You can go first on
okay.
this one.
I'm taking Bobby Roode.
Funny, because Bobby Roode is going to make the U.S. Championship glorious. I didn't want to go high pitch on that one because I didn't think.
Glorious!
I know my voice would just probably squeak. Let's try. Glorious! I didn't.
Okay, that was not bad. Yeah, I'm taking Bobby as well because this is definitely his time. And actually would give legs to him having a slight run with Baron Corbin.
Yep.
Giving Baron Corbin the rub in the situation.
See, honestly, I just don't think keeping the belt on Corbin right now is going to help him out much more.
No.
Having a feud, maybe trade it back and forth a little bit between Bobby Roode.
I wouldn't mind seeing kind of a feud between all three men. You know, going into WrestleMania, it kind of changes hands between them.
No, I want Dolph Ziggler away from Bobby Roode.
I don't want them really. Like, you might get one more match. No.
No.
What I was hoping was
because
that.
Because this feud didn't help any of them.
No. There's a feud between Bobby and Corbin.
Yep.
And Corbin and Ziggler. Not Ziggler and Roode.
They're not until, like, maybe.
It allows for Corbin to get a better push out of all of this. And lastly, what I'm saying is going to be the main event because it's about the championship. We have the champion, WWE World Heavyweight Champion.
We're calling it the world.
Okay. AJ Styles, the phenomenal one, versus, as you like to call him, Ginger U-Haul.
Ginger. You said Ginger.
Oh, I'm sorry.
Ginger U-Haul.
Ginger Mahal. Who have the Singh brothers with him. That's the way it's booked.
Or they don't. Who knows?
I'll just write in your answer for you. I know where you're going. Ginger all the way.
No.
He's never dropping the title ever again.
No.
No?
The Singh brothers.
Oh, It's the Vince Russo swerve again?
Yes.
And their finger poke of doom for the win?
No.
No? I was thinking that one of them just it's finger pokes the other. Oh, it's a blow kiss of doom. It's one brother to the other. No. Somehow pins him outside the ring.
No, it's a blow kiss of death. Killing AJ's career in WWE forever.
No. Okay. Well, I mean, if you want to kill it just there, he gets to go back to New Japan. No. I mean, win-win for everyone.
A 12-star matchup with Kenny Omega.
Oh, that would be awesome. That would be awesome.
So, if the predictions are correct that the Jinder Mahal experiment is over, that's why Kevin Owens and Sami Zayn versus Nakamura and Orton would be the main event. What a way to prove that by putting this
Putting this under.
I do agree.
Lower on the card.
Regardless of that, the title should be the main focus of the match.
Okay.
Especially since at Survivor Series, the Universal Championship and the WWE World Championship champions match were not the main event.
No. It was the main. And they still had a damn good match.
Yeah. So this would help recover that because that did damage both belts. And you don't want to be damaged to the Universal Championship. It doesn't have much.
It's supposed to be the Universe Championship.
So, but I'm going to go.
I already wrote it in for you.
I am going with Red Shoes.
Ooh, Red Shoes out of nowhere.
Yes.
Damn, Okada.
Oh, you're going to go with Okada?
Yep.
Fine. If you're going to go with Okada,
yeah,
I'm going with Nakamura.
Whoa.
He's not even in the match.
But out of the blue, Roman Reigns. One Superman punch and knocks everyone out and gets the win.
Even the audience?
Yep. Well, I mean, they decided to leave the moment his music hit. They were just like, and we're out. We're done here.
It's going to be like a cartoon where it's just like, where did everybody go?
That's it. Game over.
I'm going to say it's going to be a Superman punch to the Singh brother. One of the Singh brothers.
Just the one Singh brother.
They've melded together. One. No, he's going to hit him so hard they're going to meld together and make one. To find out it's not really twins. It's just one moving really, really fast. And what's going to happen is the force from that Superman punch is so powerful. It knocks everyone down in the arena. Falls down. The ring collapses. And Roman Reigns is just standing there with a belt. No pinfall. He's just holding the belt.
As the smoke clears.
Yes.
Roman has the belt. The ref's like, wait, how did you get that?
That's
not even the right belt.
Yeah.
It's a Universal Championship. Brock Lesnar's in his house. He's like, what? How did he get that? Seriously.
Paul Heyman's like, thief! The cops have been notified.
Yeah, he's on Twitter.
Yeah.
It's like, wait, how did you steal it?
You blew our cover.
All right.
You just lost that.
Yeah, we went way off script. Okay.
But yeah, AJ Styles.
Styles all the way.
Make it official. We should have just left it at that. No. It's just that obvious. Yeah. Do we really have to say this one? Do we?
Yeah, no.
Roman Reigns.
Oh,
yeah, no, dude, I had you going that one.
That was good.
You were like losing it.
Oh,
I was expecting you to fall out of your chair for a second.
Nope, never gonna happen. Never, ever going to happen. Anyway, so that's our predictions for Clash of Champions. Hopefully they come true, and hopefully I'm not that much of a loser anymore.
How many do we disagree on?
One, two. Two.
So you can recover your 8 points. Only two.
So wins that I get this week that you don't get, things that I get correct that you don't, I get quadruple points on.
No.
There we go. No. That's how I'm going to do it.
No.
Making up the rules as I go. You can call me Vinnie Mac.
No.
Little tiny Vinnie Mac.
No.
Anyway.
So you're potentially my 8 point lead could increase by two to make it a 10. Or it could be
moved down to six.
Moved down to six, going into the Wrestle Kingdom.
Yep.
So that, wow. That should be. If I, we come I'm back.
I'm hoping by like WrestleMania, at least it's a closer game.
Okay, if we come back next week and I'm up by 10 points, I'm just gonna say Adam, give up, just quit.
I'm just like, at this point, I'm just gonna throw names out there just to see what happens.
You're gonna really rely on Wrestle Kingdom if I'm up 10 points.
I know.
To really recover.
I know. Oh.
Wow.
Anyway, yeah, I mean, yeah. No,
be sure to,
we're done.
Fans, listeners, be sure to like us down the.
Yeah.
Turn on notifications, subscribe.
Oh,
give,
yeah.
Give us a thumbs up if you like this. If you didn't like this, don't you dare give us a thumbs down.
No, at least.
Or The Rock is going to rock bomb you to hell.
At least let us know in the comments what we could do better next time. Anyway, ladies and gentlemen, thank you so much.
We don't want to know what we're supposed to do better. We're going to do whatever the fuck we want. But do leave a comment. Just anyway. So we can mock you on air.
You, yeah, whatever.
This is not.
I would be nice to the fans.
This is not Planet Fitness. We judge everything.
Ooh. On that note, ladies and gentlemen, have a great week. See ya.